One minute, Kaylin.
Current update, didn't eat it. Not worth the points, not worth it. So, current go-to, I don't eat normal meals. I'm literally eating the salad for breakfast. I'm sorry, I'm so weird. Like, why am I like this? My thought daily. I literally take half a bag of, like, you remember school lunch lettuce where it's like iceberg and cabbage and carrots? I'm the only bitch at school that liked it. So I eat that, and then I take half a bag of that, and I take the Hampton Creek, Hampton Farms. It's called like Just Ranch. It's a plant-based ranch. And I do a serving of that, and then I do a spicy chicken, fake chicken, Boca patty. And I seem to really be all about it. The Boca patty is like 4 points. The lettuce is 0 points, obviously. You can add other vegetables. I mean, sometimes I add, I was gonna say cucumbers, but that's such a lie. I hate cucumbers with like meat. So, I'm a boring eater recently. I'm a real boring eater. So filling and basic. Oh, but then the dressing is 2 points, so it's like 6 points for a huge salad. That's super satisfying to me. Tastes like a buffalo chicken salad. Now, I really have to go. I need to eat this really quick, brush my teeth, go to Vacaville to see Amber. She's doing a Reiki on me. And then we're having like a little girl boss meeting. Everyone check out this sweet, sweet relaxing jam. Literally what I listen to in the car. Why am I psychotic? Hello, my sweet, sweet angelic friends. So, we are currently in the car at a gas station. Let me park. Just whip this around. Put it in the hole. Girl, you drunk? What's up? Beep, 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 beep. So, currently on our way to LA for a concert. We bought these tickets forever and a half ago, like almost a year ago. And I'm so excited. I'm mainly excited because Noah's so excited. He's been wanting to see this band forever. So yeah, we are on our way to, I have no idea what they're called. I won't even pretend. I won't even pretend to be a fake fan. This is 100% for Noah. So we're driving to LA, and then we have to drive back super early tomorrow morning because we have lots to do, lots to pack, lots to do. So yeah, I'm gonna do it. Yep, I miss you guys so much. And yeah, I just wanna say hi. Wanted to pop on, wanted to be like, hey, what's up, hello. Seen your pretty face. Soon as I hit that on switch. Hello. Hello, my sweet, sweet friends. It is Monday, and I'm at my grandparents' house. I just got all my stuff out of the car, nothing exciting. But getting all my stuff out of the car, I'm currently making some, well, it's in the crock, but I'm not really making it. You just take like, you know, 15 minutes to make it, and then you're done. Monday is one of those days where you just gotta get your life together. It's like one of those productive days where you just do emails, I ship some orders, now I'm here. Haley and Brody are here with me. I got stuff out of the car, I'm gonna stay here tonight. But this is the book I'm currently reading and I'm literally obsessed. I wanted to tell you guys about it. It's called Now or Never, Your Epic Life in 5 Steps, The Bridge from Where You Are to Where You Want to Be by my sweet, sweet friend Alexi Panos and her partner Preston Smiles. I'm almost done with this book and then I am moving on to this book called The Well Life, how to use structure, sweetness, and space to create balance, happiness, and peace, which balance is definitely what I need more of in my life. Purify Your Life is coming back, but I got, we already know what was going on with the doctor and all of that nonsense that was really stressing me out. And like, I was having panic attacks almost every day when I didn't know what was going on. So thank God that's over. And thank you to everyone who was so concerned and so sweet and just so amazing. We found out what was going on. Basically, they didn't know if it was like a cyst in my ovaries or, you know, just like something even worse than a cyst, or if I had like PCOS or anything like that. Like, we had no idea what was going on, and we finally found out. And so thank you to everyone who's also been like emailing me with these great UTI remedies, but they turned out to not be UTIs, which is part of the scary part. But yeah, thank goodness that is over. So thank you for everyone being so amazing. You guys are literally just the best. But I'm here making some taco soup, one of my favorite things to make for like a meal prep meal, and it's super cheap to make, which is amazing too. And oh, RIP to my nail. I literally just got these done. If you follow me on Twitter, you heard about what happened at the nail salon. Still not over it. Still not over it. Still shook. Still not okay. So yeah, I need to get back to working a little bit, and then I have some errands to run. Haley and Brody are here. Haley, do you want to say hi? Everyone misses you. They always wonder where you are. They always say, where's Haley? Where's Brody? Yeah, Pony too. Are you just cuddled up? Huh? Huh? Yeah, got some Teen Mom on for you. They love watching TV, so I always have the TV on going for them. And I'm currently working on some stuff for Light, Love, and Lace. We have a bunch of new products going up, and I'm working on a new, I guess you'd call it a product for it, but I'm actually making it, which is super exciting. We obviously have the bags that my grandma and I make, but then I'm also incorporating another product that I'm super passionate about, and so many people, we'll just have to wait and see. Marissa, hush. Okay, so yes. That's what I'm doing. Time to get to going. I haven't talked to you guys in so long, and I was talking about this on Instagram Live that I don't even realize it sometimes when I go so long without like vlogging or posting a video because I get so wrapped up in like other things. So I'm sorry. I love you guys. I'm working on balance. I really am. I'm trying. That's my number one goal right now. But I think that the number one thing that I've learned, and like if there's a tip I can give everyone, is stop thinking you should have your shit together. Especially, like, I forget that I'm so young. Like, Marissa, chill out. Give yourself a break. And you, right now, give yourself a break. Give yourself a break. You're doing great. Like, literally, I try so hard and I get so down on myself, and then it creates more of an issue, and really, it's like, just take a breath. Calm down. You good. You good. You good. I should probably put some makeup on, do my hair, something. Ooh, honey. I brought my lunch over. I know it doesn't look that, oh my God. The soup looks as good as I look right now. Not good. So I made this broccoli soup last week, and I hope it's still good. It doesn't smell that good, but I'm hungry, so pray for me. It's like kind of inspired, not kind of inspired, it is inspired by High Carb Hannah's broccoli cheddar soup, except I use like half the amount of potatoes and then add zucchini. So it's a little bit lighter. Hopefully I don't die. But I made this, and it's like, I think 2 or 3 points for this size. 2, I think, which is super good. Mm. So good. I'm currently doing an Instagram Live. This could not be brighter if I wanted it to. Everyone, say hi. We're currently talking about soulmates and twin flames, explaining the difference. Oh my goodness. Everyone, say hi. Oh, look at those hearts. Look at those hearts. Yes, yes. Having the hardest time focusing. Yes, yes. Perfect. Instagram Live, I finally got somewhat ready because I couldn't stand looking at myself anymore. One of those days. So we need to get back to work, Haley. Huh? The dogs just don't do anything. Useless. Useless. So I actually did a little bit of mini crystal shopping the other day with my friend Amber, and it was so much fun. Just going on like a little mini crystal trip, and I just posted this on Instagram, but like, on both sides, like just so beautiful. I found this really great still bite piece, which as we know, I'm obsessed with still bite. We have like little tumbled stones on the shop, but still bite's all about like really loving, just compassionate, beautiful, warm energy, and all about just love, self-love, everything about that. And it's just everything. I'm obsessed, so super happy I found that. And then we got a bunch of tumbled stones. I'm so happy I was able to find this moonstone. It's rainbow moonstone, and we had it in the shop for a while in bundles. So I think I'm gonna make more bundles with this. And moonstone is all about goddess energy, your feminine energy, just really high vibe, and oh, it's amazing. We have those moonstone necklaces. I have a moonstone bracelet I really love, and we've only had really small pieces. So these are really big and beautiful and just everything. More Dalmatian stone, which was really popular. We got a few sunstone pieces, and then some more hematite, which is currently one of my favorites. All about grounding and no negativity. And I thought that was someone in the background. I almost shit myself. Okay. Also picked up a few really, oh my god, just like hand over heart obsessed with rose quartz. So beautiful. Oh, also this apophyllite is what wet dreams are made of. Oh, she's gorgeous. Like, oh, perfect, like perfect palm size for meditation as well. Ignore my jank nail, but oh my goodness, she's amazing. If it was sunny outside, I would take this outside, but it's just dreary anyway.
Good morning, Anna. You are my baby girl. We are making coffee, and I love you so much. You're my best friend. Come here. Come here, best friend. That's my best friend. Go, best friend. Yeah. That's my best friend. Go, best friend.
That. Oh, Brody getting jealous. This is like my old school vlogs. TBT to the old vlogs and Kathy and Ralph's house on the MK channel. This is just a different Marissa Kaplan channel now. 4 ounces of almond milk for 0 points. We keep it to 0 points. Not the nose. Mwah! Say good morning! Aw. Is no one giving you attention? Needy pony, you wonder where that nickname came from. You wonder where the nickname came from. Kid Perry out there. Okay, we are now back at the apartment. I've made some spark. I'm planning my day out. I have lots of orders to ship and get those ready. I should really go get this fixed, but it's a no spending day. I talked about this on Instagram live yesterday that I'm really into like, but not into, I mean, I've always been like kind of a frugal person, and I like am always into budgeting and like saving money and everything like that, which probably would surprise a lot of people. But yeah, so what was I saying? Oh, today's a no spend day. So I have to go buy something for a video, so I have to wait till tomorrow, but that doesn't really work with my timeline, so we're figuring it out. But I have a lot to do for a video coming up, and yeah, basically shipping orders and getting ready for a video. I want to film 2 videos for you guys. I want to film my, we'll refilm my part 2 to Books Change Your Life, the video I'm talking about, but I don't know if I'm going to be able to film it if I don't have the thing. And there was something else. Oh, somebody asked me to do like kind of a Q&A, like life update chit chat video with it, which I thought would be such a good idea. And at some point I should probably get ready because this is what I look like. And yeah, this is what we're doing. I'm literally never at this apartment. Somebody said in a video the other day, they're like, why don't you just get rid of the apartment? And I'm like, you know what? That's not the worst idea I've ever heard. So we're here, we're living, we're thriving. We're doing us. But I get asked a lot about like my living situation, which I guess it's not really complicated. I mean, Noah and I practically live together. The plan has always been to move in together in October, November, when this lease is up. So yeah, we pretty much use this as my office, and I'm never here because we're either traveling with Noah or I'm spending time with my friends. But it's my safe space, I guess. I don't know. Not the worst idea I've ever heard to get rid of it though. Someone's like, why don't you just move in with your family? And I'm like, you know what? For how much time I'm there, I practically do live there. But then it's like, I'm like, is that kind of like an ego blow to like move in with your family again? Because like, I have tons of friends who did that. And like, I know a lot of you guys are my age and like so many people move home after college, which I know that I'm like a year or two after I would be out of college. Does that make sense though? I was trying to think of that. Cause I mean, I feel like in society now it's like, oh, you're supposed to do this, supposed to do that. And it's like, bitch, do you, my honeys, my babies, my loves. Honestly though, like right now in this moment, do what you need to do to be happy. If you needed to hear that today, glad you heard it from this person who obviously really looks like she has her shit together. I should like get ready. What is wrong with me? Oh my god, P.S. you guys, my sweet, sweet friend Jordan just came out with her ebook. I got mine printed out. Yoga ebook, literally everything. I'm actually going to be on her podcast in May. I don't know when it's actually going to go up, but I'm so excited. Like, I'm so proud of her. This is amazing. So the ebook, like, obviously it's an ebook. I got mine printed, like I said. But it's all about starting your own yoga journey. And as we know, I'm obsessed with yoga. Well, I'm a wannabe yogi, so I'm hoping that this will help me get more into yoga. She gave me a code to give you guys a discount. I think it's just Marissa10, so I'll link this down below. Oh, I'm just so happy for her. Like, yes, bitch, yoga. Yes, bitch, flow. She looks so beautiful in all these photos. Like, yes, Jordan. Oh, I just love it. Also, I'm obsessed with her podcast, obviously. I get a ton of questions about what podcast I've been loving, and why wouldn't she want to have me on the podcast, right? Everyone shook. But yeah, so I'm pretty sure the code's just Marissa10 that she gave me to give you guys a discount. Definitely check it out. I've been nonstop flipping through that thing and just trying to create my own sort of yoga practice, and I think that that's one of the best ways to do it. Obviously go to classes, but I'm someone who gets kind of anxiety in classes, so you know, slowly, you know, progress not perfection, okay? Marissa, do you have any idea what they're saying? Not at all. Thank you for calling me out. Hello again, my sweet, sweet friends. We are now leaving the office and we are off to the gym, huh, pups? Not to actually go to the gym, but I finally rejoined the gym because, as we know by the little series on my channel, Getting My Fit Together, we just, like, girl, I just had to do it and I did it. Like, I have an apartment gym. I just, like, am I just never use it. So let's be real, Marissa. Join a real gym. And if they spend money on it, it'll definitely motivate me to go. I don't know about y'all, but I'm like, girl, you spent that coin, you're gonna get every penny out of it. And it's the gym that I first started going to when I would like first really got into working out and fitness and stuff. So I'm actually really excited. It's like my home gym, you know? Are you guys excited? So I just have to pop in really quick and like scan my finger and set my account up. It'll take literally 2 seconds. And then my internet's not working, which is actually why I'm leaving. I have Comcast internet, and the guy, one of the guys came out the other, it was like last week. He literally, yeah, like last week he came out to fix my internet, and he said it's something like in the attic of my apartment, like the attic of our building or whatever, that it looks like the wires just keep getting discombobulated, whatever. Basically it's the wires, and I had this issue in the last apartment in Walnut Creek where it was a really, really old building and the wires just weren't working. And I'm like, but I like really need Wi-Fi to not only like, I don't know. The biggest issue is to ship orders. I have to download the labels and I have to do all that stuff. So that causes a lot of turmoil in my life. But luckily I'm moving all of my work stuff into my grandparents' house because we have like a living room and a family room or whatever. So the living room, I don't know which is which. The like more formal one we're turning into my office. So that'll be nice. But their Wi-Fi was cutting out yesterday too. So I don't know about you guys, but our Comcast has issues all the time. Like, there's always outages. I feel like everyone always always has issues though. Like, you are the best service dog that a woman could ever want. Da na na na. Both my dogs are service dogs. I don't know if you guys know that. Doubt anyone cares. It's not really that important. Huh, Bodhi. Oh, my sweet, sweet angel. My sweet, sweet angel. Hi. Hi. Yep. Feeling good over there? Yeah. It's my camera time, lady. I'm the star. Not far from the truth, honestly. I am starving. It's literally such a throwback being vlogging in this house. I don't know why. It makes me so happy. It's so weird. I made a big pot of vegan taco chili last night. It's inspired by, I started making it forever ago, but the Skinny Taste blog. It's like a Weight Watchers blog. And I just do like a vegan version of it, and I've been making it for so long now, I feel like I barely use her recipe, but I have showed myself making it in a video, which I'll try and link down below. I know I'm super bad about linking stuff sometimes, but I will do my best to remember, and it's so good, and it's like 5 points. So yeah, amazing. And then I'm gonna eat it with like half a cup of rice, little high carb Hannah Inspire, throw them carbs on there for that energy. It's my favorite sound. So right now in this moment is a perfect example of why I love Weight Watchers, because you know those days where you're like super snacky and just like nothing will fill you up? Well, I started eating that chili. I only had like a quarter of it and I started to feel super, super nauseous. So I don't know why, but I just put it back in the fridge and I'll try and eat it later. And I'm still starving. So I was like, okay. I already put in the tracker that I was gonna have some of the Thai veggie gyoza thing, so I have the points for those, and I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna bake up all of this broccoli. So I'm currently baking a whole head of broccoli, like all cut up, and it's gonna be 0 points. So the point of this is that I can eat fruits and vegetables and I don't have to like feel guilty about it. Where I was on Instagram live and I was talking about how I like that Weight Watchers like encourages you to eat fruits and vegetables, and with macros, it's like you're weighing and tracking everything. It's like if I were to eat this cucumber, I'd have to weigh the cucumber and, you know, just do all that. When it's like, it's kind of nice to, I don't know, I'm not shitting on macros at all, or if it fits your macros. I think it's great for people who can do that, but just for like my, for me personally, it doesn't really work out. I feel like Weight Watchers is great like long term for like, you know, super healthy lifestyle, man. So I'm gonna slice this whole thing up just to have on hand, and I'll probably eat some of it. I do cut the ends off though. Don't need that. Let's slice this baby up. The only like vegetable that Weight Watchers counts is potatoes, which don't tell my girl High Carb Hannah, which I love her by the way, still obsessed with her videos. Her and Derek are so effing cute, amazing, iconic, the best. Ugh, the smell of cucumbers is so, excuse me, no cucumber left behind. Oh, why? Why? Fudge. Honestly, I can only eat organic cucumbers though, and I don't know why. It's been like that way for the past couple years. Like, non-organic cucumbers taste like sour, and like, I don't know. Is that just me? Can you guys taste the difference in some foods? Like, not all foods, don't get me wrong. Actually, in non-organic apples, I feel like there's a texture difference. You know what I mean? Am I just like sounding like an apple? How's this broccoli doing? Doing great. Brody, what do you want? I'm trying to see if there's anything I want.
want to eat with this cucumber. I do love mustard.
Fun fact, guys, I put mustard on everything. The acidicness of mustard is like my favorite thing in the world. I've never, I don't think I've ever had it on cucumbers though. So good. Okay, I'm gonna put these in a Tupperware. Okay, guys, so I've been doing a bunch of photo stuff for Light, Love, and Lace. So it's been like 2 or 3 hours since I talked to you guys, and I've just been taking inventory and taking pictures for some of the new crystals going up soon. I think my eye just twitched, but I want to get this video up for you guys, so I'm gonna edit this, upload this. Sorry this was kind of a random, all over the place vlog. I love you guys so much. Thank you for your patience, and thank you to everyone who has been so unbelievably loving and supportive these past few months. I finally feel like I'm getting back to myself, and it feels amazing. So yeah, I love you guys more than you'll know, than you'll ever know, and I'll talk to you soon. Love you.